Hello friends, today I am going to talk about family Poaceae, which was earlier known as family Gramineae. It includes all the monocot plants because it is a monocotyledonous family. It mainly includes cereals and grasses, and therefore we call it as cereal family or as grass family. Today we will discuss some very common and important plants of this family, and in that same line the first plant is wheat, Triticum aestivum, and in Hindi we call it as Gehu. The wheat has approximately 30,000 varieties and 14 species, out of which 1,000 are commercially grown, and United States alone has 500 varieties. The second plant is rice or paddy. We know it as Oryza sativa. It has approximately 82,700 varieties in India alone, and out of which more than 500 are grown in Bengal. The next plant is maize, Zia maize. We are very familiar with this plant. The next plant is Bajra, pearl millet. We call it as Panicetum glaucum. It is rich in magnesium, thus very good for heart. The high fiber content maintains cholesterol level in the blood. The high antioxidant compounds help the body to fight against infection. The high iron content prevents the body from anemia. The next plant is oats. These days we hear a lot about it. The Avena sativa, commonly or in Hindi it is known as jai. It is also rich in magnesium, phosphorus and manganese, iron and zinc, vitamin B1 and B5 and antioxidants. High fiber content, and it helps in reducing the body weight. The next plant is barley or jaw. It lowers blood sugar level, cholesterol level, maintains blood pressure, and also helpful in weight loss. It is rich in magnesium, phosphorus, and potassium. The next plant is sorghum or jowar. It helps in digestion because of its good fiber content. It boosts immunity, maintains good heart health. It is high in protein, iron, vitamin B3 and copper. And it also maintains blood circulation level in the body. The next is cereal rye or cereal cereal. It is used for making flour, also used as fodder, making bread, and commercially it is used for making beer, whiskey and vodkas. The next is foxtail millet, Cetaria italica. It has a good collection of amino acids, vitamin B1, which induces the production of a neurotransmitter acetylcholine, which is very helpful in transmitting the message from muscles to nerves. It also reduces Alzheimer's disease development, and vitamin B1 also enhances our memory power. The next plant is sugarcane, Saccharum officinarum. We get sugar, jaggery and molasses out of it. Sugarcane juice is a diuretic, means it helps in the treatment of urinary tract infection, kidney stones, and improves kidney function. It also provides strength to liver and thus causes causes in the healing of jaundice. The next plant is dhub grass or Bermuda grass. It is a very important grass. We know it, we have seen it in our surroundings and we see it daily. So it treats acidity, increases immunity, purifies blood. It is also helpful in the cure of polycystic ovarian syndrome. It reduces obesity, constipation, etc. And it is an important constituent of Ayurvedic medicines. The next plant is Eleusine indica, the Indian goose grass. Next is crab grass, Digitaria sanguinalis. The very common reed is Phragmites australis. The next is Egyptian grass, Dactylotenium aegyptium. Next is smooth crab grass. It is Digitaria ischimus. This is Dallas grass, Paspalum dilatatum. This is bristle grass, Citeria verticillata. We mainly found it in the dense and crowded grassy areas. It sticks to our clothes when we go through it. The next plant is Citeria viridis. Commonly we call it as green foxtail, green bristle grass or wild foxtail millet. And it is a very important grass. Thank you very much for watching the video till the end. If you like it, please like, share and subscribe the channel for more such informative videos. Thank you.